It's different when it's a mass casualty like that, when there are so many people.
Vicksburg first responders like Jessica Cade are still recovering from the emotional night they experienced when this charter bus overturned and claimed the lives of seven people and left dozens of others injured.
I responded to Rolling Fork after the tornadoes, and that's the only thing that would compare to this in my experience.
First responders describe it as a scene unlike anything they've worked.
That was one of the worst incident that I've ever experienced.
And this is a firefighter with over 30 years of experience. Saturday, just after midnight, first responders were tasked with a severe rescue operation, all while navigating a language barrier with Spanish-speaking passengers traveling to Mexico.
We had to cut out the windshield, go in, multiple different patients laying around, injuries, blood everywhere.
They were pinned with some of their extremities underneath the seat and the bus too, so they were having to figure out how to get them out without further injuring them.
Jeremy Cooper says they instantly knew not everyone survived.
We went to them, checked them, trying to make sure if they were still alive or anything that we could do for them to possibly get them to safety. Yeah, but at that point in time, they had already passed before we even got there on scene.
I think we saved everyone that could be saved, and the system worked the way it was supposed to work.
16 WAPT News got an up-close look of the damage. All that's left behind of this charter bus is really just a shell of itself. Through these busted windows, you can see the items left behind by passengers. A jacket, a charger hanging out of the window, blankets. Now these families are looking to get back home. As you can see, they've claimed their luggages. The bottom of this bus that once carried lots of suitcases, now empty.
I've been told that there was a mother that lost a 16-year-old daughter and a 6-year-old son. And as a mother, I can't help but just feel for her.
I send those families my condolences, you know, the parents, grandparents, whoever it was at the time.
In Vicksburg, Michaela Franklin, 16, WAPT News.